it's week two of the NFL preseason, where depth charts and playbooks will be put to the test. It's the Ravens and the Panthers, next on Madden NFL 22.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to the Carolinas and Bank of America Stadium here in Uptown Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerged from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Baltimore Ravens. Brandon Gunn, Charles Davis, happy to be back alongside you. And I'll tell you what, yes, it's just week two of the preseason, but now they've got one game under their belts and a lot of guys trying to prove some stuff down on the field here today.
Not only that, these coaches like to win. And I used to think it really didn't matter who won in the preseason. Then I watched some of those shows that the NFL does, and you see the coaches in preseason after a loss jumping all over their guys. So I learned one valuable lesson. Wins and losses count no matter what time of year it is.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Now a play fake here on first down. Sliding out of the pocket. Well, he's going to take a shot right away. And got his man complete. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Sammy Watkins, 75 yards. And the Ravens have taken the early lead. We saw this plenty last year in college. He loved to take his shots downfield, and that throw, that was a thing to behold there.
And we knew that this offense was going to try and put pressure on the secondary. That was something they talked about with us. They knew that they had an advantage.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. Looking to throw. That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. Definitely the last thing you want to see here in a preseason game. We'll be right back. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Flush to his right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
That one brought back a few nightmares because when a quarterback gets outside of the pocket, your job as a defensive back, make sure you stay as deep as the deepest receiver and not let anyone leak behind you for a big play. A nice job there having discipline and not letting them connect on that pass.
And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 30. Had the offense humming on the first drive. Not much has changed here on drive number two.
No, and I think a lot of times confidence just really kicks in for a team. They may have been confident going into the game, but once you prove it on a drive, it's hard to get out of that mindset, isn't it? And look, let's face it, we can always lock in on the skill position, guys. But those big fellas up front, they're really making this offense go early in the game.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 30-yard line. Back to throw again. This will be caught once again by Brown. And in for the Ravens touchdown. Hollywood, Marquise Brown, 30 yards. And the Ravens have taken the lead. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then of course.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
A big play that time on the catch and run.
One of the things that led this organization to commit to him as a starting quarterback as a rookie, his ability to keep his eyes downfield and make plays out of the pocket, able to see the receiver while on the move and complete a really accurate throw.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He'll buy some time right. Oh, now he'll try and chuck it deep left side. And that nearly intercepted. Well, the free safety roaming into position almost had it, but it's second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll set up a throw. And that'll be incomplete. As we thought they might do here in week two of the preseason, they've left their starting quarterback out there for the second quarter. But I would imagine we will not see him after halftime.
Yeah, this is the time of year you've got to get your backup some reps and make sure you protect your starting quarterback.
And he gets this only to the 41, not near enough for the first. He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's fourth.
And partner, I would guess that in his headset, he was hearing from his coach, it's third down, don't take a sack. And in this case, he's able to avoid the pressure and get out of there. He doesn't get the first down, but he does turn a possible loss into positive yardage.
So here we go, the offense is gonna stay out there. They're going for it on fourth and 8. Back to throw here. Flushed out right. And this is caught that they say out of bounds. That would have been a first down, but he couldn't stay in. And as a result, they're going to have to give up the football. So the defense has to. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
but he
up.
He trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Back to throw now on first down. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to look deep for Watkins. And that is incomplete.
Now that's a dangerous throw right there. Moving off to his right, throwing it all the way back across field to his left. I know he had a lot of confidence in his arm. Sometimes the ball can just hang up there when it goes that distance. He was fortunate, it was just incomplete.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Eluding the pressure right. And this is caught, it's Brown. And he's gonna get this all the way down inside the 35.
There you go, there you go.
And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 34. Again, he'll drop to throw. And this is going to be hauled in by the tight end, Andrews. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
Second back, second
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
So now here in the second week of the preseason, you'd expect the starters play a little bit more than they did in week one, but not a whole lot.
So if you're an offensive coordinator, what are you looking for?
What you're looking for is things getting cleaned up as you go along, because most of your playbook's probably installed. How well are they handling it? Easy in and out of the huddle? No mental mistakes? Are they starting to look like a good offensive football team?
They go play action here on first down. They'll roll him out. Got a man. It's caught for a Ravens touchdown. Nick Boyle there to make the grab. And the Ravens have broken the tie. There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond into the game. I'm going back to the gridiron. Had some heat on that bad boy. Sometimes you throw a touchdown pass, and sometimes...
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough.
He's got a man complete. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Marquise Brown ready for the regular season with his second touchdown of the game. And the Ravens are able to show off their quick strike ability. But sometimes you just got to marvel at how these guys can throw the football. He gave that everything he had, and it was right on the money.
And as that ball was hanging in the air with the receiver streaking downfield to meet it,
so the offense set to take the field here. They will have the football with less than a minute to go in the first half. They'll come out throwing here on first down. This will be caught by Brown. And some space here. There he goes, right side. Touchdown. Hollywood Marquise Brown. His way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns. And the Ravens are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Well, like so many wide receivers, he is a threat with the ball in his hands, and he's able to do his damage here after the catch.
Yeah, and this is no ordinary run after the catch. This is supersized right here. He's able to look it in, turn up field, and then it's as simple as looking for the area where the defenders aren't. And then he outruns them all the way to the end zone.
And the next year. So we are in the final minute now of the first half as this offense gets ready to take over. They'll throw now on the final play. Flush to his right. And he gets us down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Ravens out in front. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Next, a look at the next-gen stats in that first half for the Ravens. And their quarterback's got to be icing his arm in that locker room as we speak. He is on pace to shatter some longstanding records if this pace keeps up. Meanwhile, for the Panthers, they too were able to take advantage of a soft secondary, as both of these two teams really threw the ball at will in that first half. These two coaching staffs are likely using this game as their dress rehearsal for the regular season. So some final adjustments being made. And for the call of the second half, we send it back out to Brandon and Charles.
All right, Coach, thank you. And we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Expect to see a good number of backups going forward as we are back and underway here in preseason week two. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Panthers ready to go back to work to start the third quarter. Third quarter action, and this offense will have a first and 10 as they get set for the next drive. A first throw for the backup, Jackson steps away. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Jackson from the shotgun, flushed out right. Outright, this is Boyle, the tight end. And in for the Ravens' touchdown. Nick Boyle, ready for the regular season with his second touchdown of the game. And the Ravens will extend their lead.
And boy, CD, it's one thing to watch a great run, but when it's a great run with broken contact, it's like a cherry on top. That was a nice play.
Yeah, this is a guy who runs with such balance and control.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Still operating with a comfortable lead despite the score a moment ago as they begin first and 10. Here's Jackson to throw, escaping the pressure right. He's going to find his tight end Boyle. And they work this well upfield across the 45.
That is definitely what we call on defense an uh-oh play. And what you mean by that is against Lamar Jackson. When you see him out of the pocket, your first thought is, uh-oh, he's going to try and run it. How do I get to him and get him on the ground? And guess what? That didn't happen, and his receivers took advantage.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Here's Jackson, eluding the pressure right. First down and more for Jackson. Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
First down, it's Jackson, flush to his right. That is caught by Josh Oliver, the former San Jose State Spartan. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
Partner, took a while for him to lock onto a receiver, and he finally found his man coming left to right across the formation. But by the time he got the ball to him, not much of a chance to turn upfield and make anything out of it.
Going for it all. And oh, that would get a wide up incomplete. Nearly an interception in the end zone. Probably should have been. Third down coming up.
Well, when you've got a tight end who can run, you've got to give him a shot to unlock the defense. Want to see what they can get? Taking the big shot downfield. That one winds up incomplete.
After the incompletion, here now, third and 2. Now it's Jackson, rolling to his right. And this is caught. Touchdown! Nick Boyle there to make the grab as the Ravens push further out in front.
And that was a beautiful ball right there as he waited for his tight end to come uncovered in the end zone. So give him points for patience as well. Delivered it right where it needed to be for 6 points.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
We've got a lopsided game here. I don't know, Charles, what does the handbook say that we discuss when we've got a game like this in the fourth quarter?
Hold on a second. Let me thumb to the proper page on that. Know what it says?
What?
Let's discuss how we got here. This is a dominant.
Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. 20. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown.
Devin Duvernay.
83 yards. And the Ravens continue to pour it on.
As he was shuffling right out of the pocket, you could just tell he was going to take a shot downfield. He had his eyes down there the whole way.
He certainly did. He wasn't taking...
Both offenses have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. They go play action now. Jackson sliding out of the pocket. And oh, that nearly their first pick of the game, but it falls down to the ground incomplete. Under four to go now as they come up on second down. Throwing is Jackson. He'll buy some time right. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Lamar Jackson, 59 yards. And the Ravens add on.
Well, we've certainly seen this before, CD. No one can quite electrify a crowd like Lamar Jackson, and really don't know what else to say other than that was special right there.
I think you pretty much said it all, but I go back to what you said about electrifying a crowd.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And Charles, in a very one-sided affair, I think we've reached the point in the broadcast where you and I, we may have some filling to do, right?
Yeah, I think you're right about that because we got to try to keep people around. We don't want them to change the channel. Stay with us in this game. Is that Ben Ramsauer? Are you hearing from Ben on the headset here? Tell us,
stretch
this thing out a little bit.
Get some talking points. Dig them all out.
That's what you get. A big-time producer. Keep them here.
And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Lamar Jackson,
come on, let's go.
95 yards. And the Ravens continue to pour it on.
So the lanes continue to be there for Lamar Jackson to run that football. That his second touchdown run of the game.
You know what I would like? I'd like for us to be able to go into it.
Both offenses have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. Jackson on first down. Flushed out right.
Open man is Duvernay.
Pass the 20. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
Well, where our booth is here, we can see all of the writers to our left, and their post-game stories, Charles, they have been filed for some time because this game, boy, is it lopsided.
Yeah, we can see our guy Scoop. He's even got his fedora tipped over his face. I think he's taking a nap now. Nothing left to write for him, but how gratifying has it?
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. And despite the late lead, Jackson to throw. They'll roll him out right. That's into the hands of the tight end, Boyle. And he gets this one just shy of the 35 to the 34.
Well, partner, nothing but praise from me for this offense. They have been tremendous all night long. They knew what they had to do to unlock the defense. And let's face it, this has been a master class in offensive football that we've been here to witness.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Play action. It's Jackson rolling to his right. The quick feet by Jackson, and he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A big play there on the keeper.
Partner, it's often the man coverage is easier for a quarterback to run against. You get your receivers going downfield, those guys are staying with them, and oftentimes they have their back to the quarterback, which opens up a lot of space and room, and they don't even know that he's taking off with it. What a big-time pickup on that play.
Let's
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Play action. Now Jackson sliding out of the pocket. First down and more for Jackson. And he's got it all the way down to the 12-yard line. Now a final chance to stop it here as a timeout comes in with 10 seconds left in the game. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Oh, Jackson's going to throw it out to his left. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
This defense, so many things to worry about in the red zone area, but you'd have to almost think that Lamar Jackson running the football, that might be number one.
It should be number one. And in this portion of the field where things shrink a little bit because the receivers can't run past anyone because they'll run out of real estate, you should have all eyes on Lamar Jackson when the ball is...
A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.